of a different person. My friend Aladdin was just a teenager. We used to steal.
Yes, indeed. It's the same person.
But how could Aladdin become Sultan? It makes no sense.
It's really quite a story. Would you like to hear it?
Of course.
Well, it all started about 6 months ago. Aladdin was living in a tumble-down cottage with her mother. She was supposed to be working, but Aladdin was so lazy.
I remember.
What you probably don't know, though, is that there was an evil enchanter watching Aladdin, taking notes and learning all about her.
Aladdin! Where are you?
Be quick!
thief. Let's take her before the Sultan.
You don't understand, Haddad. This is her third offense.
I don't care. She's a thief. She should be punished.
Come on, Fatima. I have to take you in. Maybe the Sultan will be merciful.
Will you at least tell my parents where I've gone?
Please let Fatima's family know what has happened.
Meanwhile, cheer Aladdin up shopping for clothes and a job. How does that sound?
That sounds amazing.
Have fun. Goodbye. Come on. We've lived here many years, but still don't hold down a job. Let's meet the people. Here comes the tailor. Perfect start. We'll outfit you while learning about her. What do you have for us today, my dear?
Maybe a hat.
Oh, a hat would be perfect to cover this mess.
It does look nice.
Here's a bag.
A bag? You'll need this for all your gold and jewels, my dear Aladdin.
Jewels?
Will you have this?
Yes. This blue silk will cover everything else up perfectly. I think that shall do. What do we owe you? Never mind, this will cover it. Be gone. What do you think of the tailor, Aladdin? She gets up and sews all these fine clothes by hand.
Looks like a little bit too much work for me.
Very well. Here comes the baker. She gets up early in the morning and bakes breads and cakes for the townspeople. How does that sound?
Although I do love delicious breads and cakes, doesn't sound too interesting to me.
Very well. Here I see the tinker. She takes metal over a fire, turns it into pots and pans, something every household needs.
No offense, but that's kind of boring.
Well, how about, I think that's a fruit vendor back there. She harvests her fruit and walks them through the town, feeding the hungry men and women.
Still too much work for me.
I know. You'd make a great police officer. Let's go meet that one over there.
I definitely don't want to be a police officer.
That's what I thought you'd say, my little fool.
What's that? What'd you call me?
Nothing at all. I'll tell you what, Aladdin. Follow me out into the desert. There, I will introduce you to a man who makes a fortune every day, doing practically no work at all. At the end of the day, he goes home, counts his gold, eats a fine meal, and listens to beautiful music. How does that sound?
Really?
Oh, sure. You bet.
So, how far is this man anyway?
It gets closer as you walk faster, my dear.
It's so hot out here, though.
Yes, and whatever you do, do not sweat on that fine silk.
I'll try my best, but there's no promises.
Well, we're nearly there.
Are we there yet?
Yes, Aladdin, we have arrived.
Really? Because I don't see a cave.
This, my dear, is a magical cave. Share his secrets with me. He's looking for an apprentice, a young person to learn at his feet, without asking too many questions. Will you go in?
Will I? Of course!
Oh, Aladdin, there's one small thing I'd like you to do for me while you're in the cave. As you walk deeper inside, you'll see a small brass lamp on a table. It's my lamp. I left it behind. It's worthless, really, but it means the world to me. It was given to me by my mother. Will you get it for me?
All right, sure. No problem. I'll see you later.
Thank you.
So did Aladdin find the man in the cave and learn how to make money without working?
No, Ollie. Don't you understand? There was no man in the cave at all. The enchanter had tricked Aladdin.
So why did she send her in?
Remember what the enchanter said about wanting a lamp?
Oh, right. So the enchanter wanted the lamp. That makes sense. But wait, why didn't she want some old lamp?
Well, I'll explain.
Hello? Is anyone in here? I've been sent to become your apprentice. I don't see anyone.
He may be sleeping in his golden bed at the back of the cave. Go deeper still.
Okay. Hello?
Aladdin come back with that lamp.
But what about my apprenticeship? You said there was a man in here who would teach me how to get rich without doing any work.
For heaven's sakes, Aladdin, you have a bag full of gold and jewels. Just give me the lamp.
Let me out.
Certainly. Hand me the lamp and I'll open the door.
All right. Wait a minute. You said there was a man in here who would teach me his trade. But there was no man. And you said this lamp was worthless.
Just give me the lamp.
Open the door and I'll give you the lamp.
Give me the lamp and I'll open the door.
Let me out.
Lamp first.
But aunt.
Don't you understand, Aladdin? I am not your aunt. I am a powerful enchantress. Now
what?
Give me the lamp.
If you're so powerful, why don't you just use magic to get the lamp?
Don't tempt me, or I will turn myself into a dragon and breathe fire. Now give me the lamp.
And then you'll turn into a dragon? No, I'm staying right here, and I'm keeping the lamp.
Then stay.
She must have gone home by now. So what job did you take and how much will you be making?
Aladdin, you didn't lose your job again? What happened?
We were tricked, Mother. She took me to a cave and it was filled with silver and gold and diamonds and jewels, but all she wanted was this stupid lamp.
So a cave filled with gold and diamonds and jewels? That doesn't sound so bad. Where is it?
Oh, Mother. When she shot me into the cave, I thought I was done for. And I threw the silver and gold and gems away.
So she shut you in the cave with all that wealth?
Yes, she wanted the lamp, you see?
I see. So you jewelry and yet kept the lamp.
I thought that if she wanted the lamp so badly, it must have been worth a fortune.
I see. So, after throwing away a king's fortune, how exactly did you get home so fast? You've only been gone 3 hours.
Well, that's the incredible part of the story. You see, as I threw myself to the ground, thinking I would die in that cave, a beautiful genie appeared. And she said, "Your wish is my command." So I commanded her to open the cave and send me home. And here I am.
I see. A beautiful genie appeared out of nowhere, offered to give you anything you wanted. Brought you home by magic. And all you have to show for it is a dirty old lamp. Nice work, Aladdin.
I'm telling the truth, Mother.
All right, bring the genie back.
But I don't know how.
I see. So, no money. You got no job. But at least we've got a dirty old lamp.
And all the gold we were given, too.
I spent it.
Oh, no. My clothes. Can't you give them back?
I may have to. But wait. Take a closer look at that lamp. I mean, if our former friend liked it so much, maybe there's something about it. Maybe it's made of gold. Why don't you try rubbing some of that tarnish off?
I'll try.
Greetings, Master. I am the genie of the lamp. Your wish is my command. Hush! You're here to observe and soak up my wisdom.
Well, excuse me. I graduated top of my class at the School of Genie Science, and I think I know a thing or two about granting wishes.
Excuse me. Who is the senior genie here?
Oh, pooh. You're out of date. Not like us post-millennial genies.
Me? Out of date? Did he? I'll show you.
Are you both genies? What are you doing here?
I am the genie of the lamp, and your wish is my command.
Our command!
So there. Well. You see, Mother? There's a genie. And this one is even stronger and more powerful than that one in the cave.
So your wish, our wish is your command?
No, no. Aladdin is the one who rubs. So she is my master. She must ask 3 things of me, and I must obey.
3 things, Aladdin, you have to think very carefully.
Well, in that case, my first wish is this. I wish to become rich and powerful.
That's 2 wishes, but I'm happy to grant them both. Master, I will make you rich and powerful. But you can also become ruler of this land, if that is your dream. The Sultan grows old and needs an heir, someone she can trust to take over the kingdom. But while the Sultan is a good ruler, she is very vain. If you can flatter her, call her great and glorious.
I could become the Sultan?
Yes, Master.
Teach me how.
We would be glad to help.
No, you're not. Not yet.
And why is her visit such good news, your graciousness?
As you know, I'm getting older. And it takes my place must be powerful and wise.
As am I, your graciousness.
And young and kind. Perhaps this young princess will be the one.
But your graciousness, I thought you would choose me to become sultan.
As I've told you before, vizier, you may have power, but you are neither wise nor kind, nor especially young.
How can you say I'm not kind? Just yesterday, I gave a lollipop to a little boy, and...
I hear the fanfare! She arrives!
Wine. Servant?
Thank you, your graciousness. You are very kind. But I'm only 15.
Oh.
Three.
It is so hard to keep good service these days. Tell me, princess, how do you manage your court?
How do you keep them happy?
He
Many of us subjects complain of poverty. Some even steal. It's a problem.
Well, we give them anything they want. We have a great business. A police officer and merchant have asked to see you. May they enter and ask for your judgment?
Well, all right. Perhaps this will be a good way to learn more about how the princess rules.
Ah, yes. This is one of those street urchins I warned you about, Your Graciousness. She's been arrested now for the third time, and now at last our law is clear. A third crime must be punishable by death.
Her name's Fatima. I've seen her around.
Excuse me?
Oh, but she looks so young and so poor.
Her age and income have nothing to do with it.
Let Princess Fahee decide this case.
Thank you, Your Graciousness. I've judged many cases in my land. Police Chief, what is this girl's crime?
She and another young woman were caught stealing in the marketplace. They stole a few pieces of fruit and embroidered cloth. Nothing of great value.
But it was the third time. Yes, and if we don't make an example of this girl, our streets will never be safe.
Well, that's not really true. I mean, she is a thief, but all she's stolen are—
Silence!
Tell me, girl, what is your name?
Fatima.
And tell me, Fatima, why did you steal three times?
We are poor. We have nothing. Those fruits and the pennies we could make from the cloth would be enough for my family for 2 days.
And why don't you work for your keep?
I did work, but then my mother got sick, and my brothers and sisters needed me at home. Now that my mother is better, I can work again. I've been looking for work for weeks. And now, who will hire me if I'm in jail? And if I'm executed?
You have no work, and so you steal. You break the law. You should be punished.
You should. Not only did I lose a lovely piece of fruit, but I've had to close my shop to come here to argue my case. And tomorrow I'll have to travel and buy more wares, and I'll lose money again.
So you, Fatima, need to work so you won't have to steal. And you, merchant, need someone to look after your shop while you're away. Then here is my judgment. You, Fatima, will work for the merchant. You will help sell her wares and keep her shop clean. For 1 month, the merchant will pay you nothing. After the month, the merchant must pay you for the work that you do. But if you steal again—
No, I won't steal again. Not if I work.
Good! Just the judgment I would have made.
But Your Grace, this is wrong. The thief should be punished, not rewarded.
She will pay for her mistakes, but I think she will learn from them as well. Princess, your decision is fair and just. And I have an idea.
May we go? Because if we're going to release this prisoner, I'm going to have a lot of paperwork to get through.
Yes, yes, yes. You may go. But do as you've been bidden by the princess. And you, young lady, don't let me see you here again.
No, you won't, Your Grace. Thank you, princess.
You're welcome.
Come on, Fatima. Let's get out of here before anyone changes their mind.
Princess, your decision is fair and merciful. In fact, the merchant's business may thrive with Fatima working for her. She seems like a capable girl. If only she can earn enough for her family.
If she doesn't go back to stealing.
Good point. Servant! Yes. Follow that young woman to her home. See what the family needs to survive. We must be sure they have enough to eat while she works off her crime.
Yes, Your Graciousness. I'll be sure to bring along some food and water, as I'm sure they're hungry. I remember when my father lost his job. It was—
Thank you. Now off you go. Servants these days. Fahid, you are both kind and wise. I wonder if you might be the person to become heir to my kingdom.
No, Your Grace, remember, you sent your heir
to learn more about Tahib.
No, wait. I have a better idea. Tell Tahib that she can become Sultan, but under one condition. She must build a glorious palace right here next to yours, and she must build it in just one day. If she succeeds, you will know that she can command many people and achieve great things.
One day? But no one can do that.
A truly powerful ruler can.
Very well. Fahim, would you like to become Sultan after me?
Oh, yes, your graciousness.
Then, I will set you a test. You must build a palace as glorious and beautiful as mine, and you must build it within one day.
Let me consult with my servant. Your graciousness, I accept. Not only will I build a palace as glorious as your own, but I will build it in just 1 hour.
1 hour? But that's impossible!
Not for a person who is truly powerful. I will raise my palace at noon tomorrow from the balcony of your palace.
So Aladdin did such a good job doing Fatima's case, and the sultan that said Aladdin could be the next sultan?
Yes, but only if she could build a palace in 1 hour.
But that was easy, right? I mean, a genie can do anything.
Yep, and that's exactly what happened.
Well, here we are, ready to see a palace rise from the desert in a single hour.
Will you do it?
Watch and see, your graciousness. Servant! Are you prepared to raise my palace from the sand?
I am, your highness.
Then with the power I command, I shall raise my palace. Palace, arise.
What? they started to work together.
Oh no! What happened to Aladdin? Is she okay? Did they hurt her?
What happened was this.
I hear there will be a new sultan.
So it seems. After all the work I've done, I'm not going to be sultan after all. Instead, I'm going to be pushed aside by some unknown princess.
You sound angry.
Angry? I'm furious. Only I can get rid of that Princess Fahid. The sultan loves her, but she knows nothing about her.
I can tell you something about your Princess Fahid. She's no princess. She's just a street rat named Aladdin.
No, you must be mistaken. This princess brought gold and jewels and built a palace in a single hour. No street rat could do that.
That much is true.
Then show me how it was done.
I can't now, but if you help me, I soon will. What would you give to destroy the happiness of this young upstart? I have information and powers that could do just that, while also helping you to become sultan.
Yes, yes! But wait, no one gives something for nothing. What do you want in exchange for all that information and power?
Just one thing, Grand Vizier. Something so small and simple. Inside the palace, there's a lamp. It's a small, ordinary lamp, but it means the world to me. Bring it to me, and I will destroy your rival.
And that's all you want? Just an old lamp?
That's it. But it won't be easy. You must wait until Aladdin and his mother have left the palace, and then...
Newlands!
mine.
Your wish is my command, oh master.
What's this?
It was this lamp and that genie that helped a street rat like Aladdin become the Sultan's heir. And it was that genie that razed the palace in a single day. But it shall be we who destroy it. Genie, my first command is for you to destroy Aladdin's palace.
Master, I cannot destroy what I have created, but I can move the palace far away where Aladdin will never find it.
Very well. Make it so.
Wonderful! The Sultan will be horrified. Aladdin will be destroyed.
So I have fulfilled my share of the bargain?
Oh, yes, completely.
Lovely.
Your graciousness, come to the balcony. It's terrible.
What is it? Oh, no. What happened to the princess's palace? How could such a huge building just disappear?
Well, it was built in just 1 hour. Perhaps it really was a mirage.
And where is the princess? Servant, the princess and her mother are in the town. Fetch them and bring them to me.
Yes, Your Graciousness.
What can this mean? Is the princess a fake? Can I trust her to become the next Sultan?
I warned you, Your Graciousness.
This morning,
I learned that Fahid is no princess. She is really just a street rat by the name of Aladdin.
No street rat can bring such riches and jewels. I'll build a palace from nothing.
She has no power or riches of her own. She had the help of a magical genie.
A genie? Well, that would explain the palace. But how can you explain her wisdom and kindness? What should I do? I can't tell the people their next Sultan is a street rat.
I have a plan, Your Graciousness. Tell Fahid that she can become Sultan if her palace returns by midnight tonight. If she succeeds, well and good. But if she fails, you know that she has made a fool of you and endangered the entire kingdom with her crimes. And there is only one punishment for such a terrible crime.
Death.
It's gone. How is that possible?
My palace and my jewels and my dresses and my servants, what are they?
Princess, where is your palace?
Your Graciousness, I don't know. It seems to have somehow disappeared.
You have tricked the Sultan and endangered the entire kingdom with your crimes.
But
I trusted you, Princess. I believed in you. But if you cannot bring back the palace by midnight tonight, you will have to pay the price.
What price? What is she talking about?
Your daughter will be executed at dawn.
No, that must be wrong.
I'm sorry, but that's my decision. Please, please bring back the palace, please.
Graciousness, I'll do my best.
I don't understand, Aladdin. What happened to your palace?
I don't know, Mother. I just don't know. Without the lamp, I have no genie. I can't bring the palace back.
Well, what are we going to do?
I don't know. What's going to happen to us? Why did I ever think I could become the Sultan?
Wasn't.
done well so far. By moving the palace, you've helped me destroy Aladdin and gain the power I crave. All that's left to do is return the palace to its rightful place, and the Sultan will make me ruler over all the land.
What about the Grand Vizier?
Who cares about the Grand Vizier? I certainly don't.
Not so fast!
Aladdin, how did you get here? No matter. You're unimportant now. I've moved your palace where no one can find it. If it's not returned by dawn, you face execution.
Really powerful people can do more than just move things around, you know. They can also do magic without the aid of a genie, too.
Oh, and what exactly can really powerful people do?
Really powerful people can create a storm inside this palace.
How did you do that?
It's simple, when you know how. I can also turn myself into a tiny mouse. But why should I? You've seen a demonstration of my power. Now, let's see a demonstration of your power.
I am a powerful enchantress. I might not be able to change my shape the way a genie can, but I can certainly turn myself into a mouse.
Prove it.
I shall.
Thank you. are